You and Me Murrawee by Kerri Hashmi and Felicity Marshall. We walk the same round earth, you and me Murrawee. Past the ancient granite rocks, we run down the slope to the river. Hearts beating in time, I follow your bare footsteps. We move the same dust and bend the same grass in our stride. The water is sparkling in the sun and it calls us near. You've made a mudslide down the bank. You sit on it and squeal as you slip the other children into the cold, clear water. Your uncle is fishing upstream and he warns you not to frighten the fish. I give the slippery dip a miss, take my shoes off and paddle near the edge. The mud is squidgy between my toes. My father calls to me to watch out for broken glass. We each pick up a stick and draw pictures in the same patch of river sand. You and me, Murrawee. You draw a kangaroo, mine is meant to be a horse. We walk along the riverbank, balance our way over the rocks and scratch at the lichen. I follow the footprints of someone's dog. You think you've seen a wallaby spoor. Our fathers are going out in their boats. They leave from their little launching bay where the river bank is low. My father has a rowboat. He's teaching my brother how to handle the oars. Your father has a canoe. He's taking your brother to show him how to trap fish. We both watch them from the same spot on the shore, in the shade of the old river red gum. We can see the scars on it where your father cut his canoe. The ducks on the river expect food from campers. They swim up to me and I throw them some bread. You know where their nest is. You swim across into the reeds to collect some eggs, which you give to your mother. She passes you her digging stick and asks you to gather some of the reed roots too. She'll cook them all tonight. We climb up the path above the river, you and me, Murrawee. The magpies are nesting too. They swoop on us and we both run ducking. The river water you are carrying splashes from your coolamon. A cool breeze is picking up and it blows our hair and our faces. It brings the scent of food and the smoke of campfires. Our tummies rumble. I can smell sausages and onions frying. For you, the fish, the eggs and roots are baking. We share food with our families. The ants clean the crumbs and take them back to their nests, as they have always done. As we nestle in by the campfires in the dark, your grandmother takes you into her arms and tells you the old, old stories of the river, its creation, its floods and its droughts. I strain to hear her stories, but they are lost in the winds of time. Instead, I listen with my family to songs on the radio, sung by people who have never seen this river. We lie down in the same hollow in the sand, you and me, Murrawee. The night is cool. You lie between two fires and I snuggle into my sleeping bag. You hear the bunyip calling from the river. The people in the next tent keep me awake for a while. The moon shines on both our faces. We sleep under the same stars, unchanged yet ever changing, which spark like campfires in the sky. We breathe the same air, you and me, Murrawee, but we will never meet, for we live 200 years apart.